Hello and good afternoon, everyone. This is a pleasant Wednesday afternoon. It's been pouring like cats and dogs in Mumbai. I would like to welcome you to Spotlight with Suman on this beautiful afternoon. And I hope that you're looking forward to this Insta Live. And each time, each week, we make sure that we bring some unique guest who is able to provide a lot of value to each one of you. Hi everyone. So the whole idea of doing Insta Live with ICBI Image Consultants is that they bring a lot of variety in terms of showcasing their work, their personal life, their professional life, their, you know, mindset, what they think and what they feel about this profession. And what exactly is image consulting all about, and how are they balancing their work life? So the guest for today is a very dynamic lady, my personal favorite once again, somebody who's very emotionally connected with me, all the way from Chennai. She is a certified image consultant, a life coach, posh enabler. She's also a POCSO torchbearer, which is protection of child from sexual offences. And she is also the Chennai chapter president of Image Management Professionals Association. So I would like to welcome Aruna Das, who is 10-year-old in the image consulting industry. And she has been closely associated with me for a very long time. So waiting for Aruna to send in her request. Hi Ankit. Hello Sushma. Hi Astha. Hi Vikas. Hi, Aruna.
Hello, ma'am. Hi.
Welcome to Spotlight.
Ma'am, you're matching.
Yes, we are matching.
Thank you.
We are always matching in some way or the other.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely.
How are you doing?
Good, good. Very good. Such a pleasure to see you.
Absolutely.
Virtually, sahi. So, such a pleasure.
How's the weather?
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Very good, very good. It's much better now. So it's been raining for some time now. So it's good. It's nice. It's very good.
So I was just telling everybody that how emotionally connected we are together. And since you are in Chennai, we are still very closely associated. And in some way or the other, we are always in touch. And you are 10 years
yes.
old in the industry, in the image consulting industry. So usually people don't like the word old. But when it comes to seniority and when it comes to being old in the profession, people always like this kind of compliment. So I'm sure you're happy about the fact that you're 10-year-old in the industry.
Yeah, close to. Yes. Yeah.
So
it's nice. It's a great feeling.
Absolutely. Absolutely. And I think our association goes all the way back 10 years ago. I mean, almost a decade ago. And we yes. have been knowing each other. We have known each other for almost that much time now.
Yes,
so I
yes,
want to know,
yes.
Aruna, that as a wife, a mother, and image consultant, as well as a corporate trainer, how do you manage wearing different hats, and what keeps you going all throughout?
Ma'am, one more important role, which is very close to my heart, IMPA chapter president.
Yes, 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 absolutely. How can we forget that?
Yes.
What keeps you going?
Ma'am, I have a huge support from my family. My husband is my pillar, and my son is old enough now to take care of himself. So they just help me out with be it household chores, or I mean, now I'm talking about household chores, obviously, because of COVID. But they're always been there to support me and stand by me. So that's the support side of it. what keeps me going is I love all of these roles that I play. So I every day I just want to give in my best, and that's what keeps me going.
So tell me something. I mean, we are facing this pandemic situation and we are all under lockdown. So has this situation impacted your work, and what has really helped you, you know, taking care of your work while you are there in the pandemic situation?
Right. Ma'am, you are aware more than anyone else that I was supposed to travel from March 12th to April 21st. And it was, I was supposed to have back-to-back sessions. My pipeline was ready from March to June. So that way, has it impacted? Yes, it did impact, because all of these have been pushed for some time. Somewhere it's not impacted me mentally or emotionally, because these are my long-term clients and I know they, for a fact that they will come back. So that way there was an impact. Having said that, there was work that came in. I mean, April and May, it was a little difficult for me to manage home and work. So I focused mainly on one-on-ones. But then I built the pipeline for June, July and August. So if you look at it, not much of an impact, but I mean, the sessions being pushed, that way there was an impact. Otherwise, there was work,
still,
that's what, yes.
Are you still working during pandemic?
Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Absolutely. I mean, not going out, but everything is online now.
Okay.
So everything is getting me out of my comfort zone.
So was online not your comfort zone?
No, not at all. It wasn't my comfort zone. Of course, I've done one-on-ones online. I've been doing that for the last 4 years because I have clients abroad as well. So one-on-one was fine, but you know, doing a session, a Zoom session for 40-50 people was something that I was not comfortable. Now I've got used to it. So now there's no problem. Yeah, but initially that was like a...
So the lockdown has helped you in some form or the other?
Oh, a lot. A lot of introspection has gone into this during this time. It's helped me a lot. I did 120 hours of learning. I mean, I every day, some or the other webinar I used to attend, and I kept updating myself. So that was another thing that this lockdown did to me, which is very nice.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic. So Aruna, image consultants have a choice to decide who are the clients that they would like to work with. So
Right. What
are the clients you have basically chosen to work with largely? I mean, what are the typical clients that you are more comfortable and you have made a choice to work with?
Right. Ma'am, I've been, over the years, I have worked with almost everybody in the sense in the corporate world, right from the junior executives to senior executives. But last couple of years, I've focused mainly on senior leaders, politicians and celebrities in the one-on-one side. And in the corporate world, again, from mid-level to senior management is that I focus on. So that's the kind of work, mainly it's senior leaders. Yeah.
Okay, before I go to the next question, I'm just complimenting you that you're looking very nice in this sari.
Thank you. I dressed up for you. And what a pleasure, we both are wearing this.
Usually people wear a lot of westerns when they come for these kind of conversations, but I've seen you for the first time wearing a sari. So that's a very pleasant surprise for you know, an Insta Live session, and which is a very, very nice thing to do.
I'm always something to do. So that's what I believe.
Alag se dress up hoke aaye ho aur bahut acche lag rahe ho for a change. That is why I thought that I'll compliment you.
Thank you so much.
Aruna, you've come from a corporate background, right? And you have been a part of an organization by the name of Accenture. Now, my question to you is that what has inspired you to change your domain and get into image consulting space? Because usually people who come from corporate, they go to another corporate or, you know, I mean, they decide to do something of their own, like a consulting in the corporate industry. But this was you know, a very different space for you. I mean, I would not have imagined anybody coming from a hardcore corporate to, you know, getting into image consulting and soft skills training. So what has really inspired you to get into, you know, image consulting after being in a corporate sector?
Right. Right. Ma'am, I've been, as you know, I was on sabbatical for some time and I really didn't want to get back to the 9-to-9 corporate rut. I was very sure because I believe that anything that you get into, you have to give in your 200%. Otherwise, don't get into it. And I was very sure going back to the corporate, job was not my cup of tea. And if I have to talk about who I am as a person, I love dressing up. I love talking to people. People skills is my core skills. A lot of people came to me with their problems or when they were stuck in life or when they needed motivation. A lot of people came to me even before I joined Image Consulting. So I was always a solution provider for a lot of people. And all I had to do was hone my technical skills and join ICBI. And it just became a natural extension of who I am as a person. And that's why Image Consulting. And I absolutely love what I'm doing.
Great. So share with us one of your exciting client experiences. I think most of the people who are here would like to also know that what are the kind of clients you handle and what is the kind of experience that you've had. So maybe one of the best experiences that you would like to share with us.
Sure. But ma'am, can I elaborate? I mean, it's like a lumbar story. Is that okay? Okay. So there's this client of mine and probably the best client. In fact, one of them is attending from their part, from their side, one of them is attending today. I went to this company to meet the country head and the L&D head. When I walked into their office, when I walked into their cabin, they asked me, do you have experience in our industry? I said, no, I don't have any experience in your industry. So it was a little taken aback. Log to kuch bhi bol dete to, get some work. But she's standing here and she's here and she's saying that, she's never worked in our industry. Then they asked me, so I was 3 years into the system by then in Image Consulting. So then he asked me, how many years of experience do you have in your industry? I said, 3 years. So it was again a little taken aback. I said, my industry is 5 years old and I'm three and a half years into the system. That means it automatically makes me a senior. So I know my work well and I know my industry. I mean, I know my craft well. So that's what is important. Then the next question he asked me, so do you really know anything about our company? Luckily, I had done enough research. I said, yes, I know enough about your company. And they were happy with that. So they said, okay, what we want you to do is do a 90-minute demo session for our senior leaders. If they like it, I mean, they like your session, then we will come back to you. I said, great. I did a 90-minute session for their senior leaders. And there was very good feedback. And I got a call from the admin saying that the vendor management team saying that please send a proposal. And I send a proposal. When I send the proposal, I got a call from the country head himself saying, please change the amount on the invoice that you have sent. And I was very taken aback. I was very upset that why is it that, they're asking me to reduce the amount. I said, but it's according to the market. Whatever is the market is what I'm charging. She said, no, you didn't get what I said. I asked you to increase the amount. Ma'am, wow. I was so shocked and surprised that a client coming back to you and telling you, please increase the amount. So I was very happy. I sent the proposal. Of course, it had to get approved. It got approved. And then I went back to them. Ma'am, I've done a year's work with them. I did 40 sessions with them over a year. And they are like my biggest clients till date. So I did this. So before I started, I went and I met the CEO, the country head and the L&D head. And before I could ask them, they said, wait, let us explain as to why we increase the amount, because we're very sure that's running in your mind. So let's explain that to you first. Ma'am, there were two other trainers who were there. So it's typically three trainers who go and do these demo sessions. So final three. And the other two had 30, 35 years of experience. But in the 90-minute time that they had, all they did was speak about themselves. Because it was a big deal, right? I mean, it was 40 sessions. So they wanted to sell. And all I did was, I mean, this is what they told me. All I did was focus on the session. The 90 minutes that I was there, all I did was, ensure that they have takeaways. So I didn't focus on if I will get those 40 sessions or not. So they said that was one thing that we were really happy that you are more focused on your clients than on yourself. Second is you had the honesty to tell us that I have not worked in this industry. Having said that, I can really do a good job if you give me this project. So we believed your confidence, and it came across when you did, you know, that confidence did come across when you did the 90-minute session as well for us. And then the last thing which really hit me was they said, हमारे सामने जब कोई honest बंदा खड़ा है और वो कह रहा है कि मुझे ये नहीं पता, how could we not give you what you were worth? And we felt that you were much more worth than what you had mentioned. And that's a client which I will never ever forget. And another thing that I learned is be honest. You know, if you don't know something, you don't know something. Don't try and, you know, cover it up or say things, because at the end of the day, honesty really pays. So that's a client experience that I absolutely love.
And I think this has been one of your oldest clients, right? If I'm not mistaken.
Yes. Yes, absolutely. You're right. 7 years, 6.5 years. Yes.
Because
I did a 2-year engagement with
two.
Yes. And in fact, Rakesh sir sent me the content for this session as well. The initial 2013. Yeah, sir sent me the content. So amazing. The journey has been so beautiful when I look back today.
Brilliant. So you have been in the industry now for over a decade now, Aruna. Almost a decade.
Yeah.
What keeps you inspired, and how do you succeed in managing your own image?
Wow, ma'am, can I also share an example here with this? Is that okay?
Yes.
Sure. So, my tagline is transforming lives, and that is exactly what I do. I transform lives, and when I say I transform lives, the end result is beautiful. Right from the time a client comes to me to, you know, from the first session till they leave, it's beautiful. I mean, I see the transition, I see the transformation, and I feel and I believe that I'm doing something worthwhile in my life. It is such a beautiful journey. I mean, these people, when they leave, there's so much of respect and love for you as their consultant, as their coach. So that's what keeps me inspired. And about managing my own image, this slightly a funny incident. So we were on the highway from Chennai to Kerala, and my husband prefers driving early in the morning when we drive. So he said, let's leave at 3. So I got up at 2, I got ready, I applied lipstick, eyeliner, kajal, and he was like, what's wrong with you? I mean, you know, 3 in the morning, kaun tayar hota hai itna? I said, nahi, you never know kaun kaha mile. He said, seriously, highway pe, we are just doing door to door, and maybe we may take a break during breakfast. I said, jo bhi, I'll get ready. I got ready. And when we got down for breakfast at 7 in the morning, we stopped, and I see my client right in front of me. Ma'am, imagine if I was dressed shabbily or I didn't take that effort to dress up. And, you know, you just preach something. It doesn't make sense. And the client, when she hugged me, again, she's a long-term client, when she hugged me, she said, hawa ka jhoka ho aap. Kitna fresh lag raha hai aapko hug karke. So you feel so good. Right? Your clients are also happy. And ma'am, the best thing is she was dressed. She is someone who has never bothered about dressing before, and she was dressed. Imagine if I wasn't. So, you know, walking the talk is something that, you know, I've lived through in this last 10 years. It's, and I just walk the talk.
And you give a image with your husband?
Sorry? Yes, of course. I said, bola tha. Of course. I said, bola tha. After that, he will never say anything. Jab mujhe sabji bhi lene jana, I get ready and go. So he's like, okay, please, you never know who you meet. So yeah, so it's been nice. And now my image is become, initially I had to manage my image to answer the question, but now I just sustain it. And it's more a part of my life and my lifestyle now. I just walk the talk.
Absolutely. So there are many people who undertake corporate assignments but fail to get repeat business. In your case, things have been different, Aruna, because I have seen that you have closely worked with many organizations and with a lot of repeat work. So what has worked for you, and what, according to you, are 3 important ways to retain clients? I mean, this is something which definitely a lot of people would like to know and understand from you, that how have you managed to retain clients, and what has been your mantra?
Right. Ma'am, number one thing, even I spoke about this in the conference, for me, it's trust. My clients trust me. And I have got a lot of work because of that trust. Again, as I said, So how do you build this trust? The honesty that I said, I don't know something, I don't know something. I mean, I don't know. I mean, I just say that to them. And over the years, that trust builds. And once they trust you, they will give you a lot of work. And second thing is, you have to really believe in, you know, genuine well-being of your clients, be it one-on-ones or corporate. When the client knows that you really believe in their well-being. I'm more an insider today to most of my corporates, ma'am. In fact, when I go, if there's a board meeting happening and I'm waiting outside, the client will say, "Arey Aruna, usko bula lo." So they don't make me wait out because it's a board meeting, right? And if there is an important meeting and I'll say, "Do I step out?" So typically when you have corporate trainings, the leaders come in between to speak to the team. And when I ask them, "Do I step out?" They're like, "No. Please stay there. Aap to hamare ho." Ma'am, in fact, this is one of the clients that you have given me. One of the manufacturing companies, I'm not going to name them, the 3 years that we have worked with them. Yes. They say this, that if Aruna kar rahe hai, to kar lene do. So they know genuinely there is an interest from my side for their well-being. So when we look at that, what happens is the focus moves from me to them. And then automatically, so there's trust, there's genuine well-being. And the third one is giving in your 200%. Ma'am, I've seen when people start, they give everything to the client. Ki haan, ye bhi karna hai, wo bhi karna hai. But over the years, somewhere they're like, "Achha, ye topic, I've done this for so many years." It doesn't matter. So giving in your 200%, I believe in what Amitabh Bachchan says. Every scene is his first scene. Every movie is his first movie. Every ad is his first movie. And I completely believe in that. For me, every training is my first training. I put in that effort even today. It may not be like utna jitna dalna padta tha, but I still put in a lot of effort to customize. So customization is another thing. So these are the three things because of which my clients come back to me.
So I guess you must be their favorite, yeah, all-time favorite because of all these attributes that you carry with you.
My clients say Fevicol ka jod hai, tootega nahi.
So, in continuation to that, tell me what, according to you, are the most essential attributes to become a successful image consultant?
Wow. Ma'am, I was watching Modi ji today. Today is Skill India Mission. They complete 5 years and I complete 5 years of IMPA today. So, sorry, offline, that's so close to my heart and I just spoke about it. So, one of the top things Modi ji also said was learning. I believe, and I mean, you know it more than anyone else, you know that I have always updated and upgraded myself right from day one. I've always learned. So, my suggestion or my thing to the newcomers is that it is very important that you learn. Whatever be your specialty, just work on that. Just focus on that particular thing and work more on that. Learn more on that. Keep upskilling and upgrading yourself. That's one. Second is focus. Ma'am, many people, most people, what happens is if you're running a race, you either run behind your competitors or you're running behind your competitors or you're running behind your idols. So, usse kya hota hai? You lose your track. You catch your track and you run. You have your focus. You have your goals. Run behind your goals. You will reach there much faster and nobody can move you from that. And the third thing is living image consulting. Ma'am, I eat, sleep, breathe, drink image consulting. It's matlab kehte na kan kan mein hai mere. I am a chalta firta, you know, it's just there in me. It's there so much in me. So, and I believe that if you believe in what you're doing and you believe in yourself, when you go out to your clients or when you, be it your social setup, be it your personal professional setup, be it any setup, when you live image consulting, you don't have to put an effort to sell something. It just flows and it flows beautifully. And even when you do your corporate trainings, the session is far impactful than what it would be otherwise. So these are the three things: learning, focus, and live image consulting, live your passion. So these are the three things that I feel can make you a successful image consultant.
Absolutely. And I think if everybody abide by these three attributes which are required, I think that there is no looking back, especially for somebody like you. It has been no looking back for you. And I mean, I think all other aspiring image consultants or people who are in the process of becoming an image consultant, if they abide by these three traits or qualities or attributes, I think, I mean, they are sorted, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. Because you've worked on their niche, and once you are so good, then you are not competing with anyone else. You're just running your race, and it may take time, but once you're there, you've built on a strong foundation, so nobody can take that place from you. So, yeah.
Fantastic. So, how were your early days when you took the plunge and you got into this industry? And I'm sure you must have faced a lot of challenges during that time, right? When you came into from a corporate background. So, what?
Not really.
Not really. Okay. So, share something.
I don't know if it's because I've not looked at it as a challenge, or I was looking back at my journey. I was introspecting today, and I couldn't see any challenges for that matter. It's been a beautiful journey. I mean, last 9 years has just been a beautiful journey. I don't think God's grace, touch wood. I've been extremely lucky wherein I've actually not faced challenges, ma'am. I've just lived it, and I've lived it happily.
So how is today's Aruna different from the one I knew 10 or 9 years ago? I mean, what is the difference between the Aruna that was there 9 years back vis-a-vis the Aruna of today?
Wow, ma'am. This is something that more than anyone else at ICBI, you know it. You know me so well. Today's Aruna is far more confident, far more emotionally strong. Today's Aruna knows to take a stand for herself. She's very well updated about what's happening around. So today's Aruna is all that. Today's Aruna is a very different Aruna. And I am who I am, and I could bring that change in my life because of few people. The first and the most important person is my husband. He is my mentor. He is the strongest pillar that I have. He stands by me like, go do it. I'm there. That's a huge support that I've got. And that helps me bring that change. My son, I think he's logged in. He actually got an Instagram account to see his mom live. That's the kind of support that I get from my family.
How old is your son?
13.
Wow.
So that's the kind of support I get from my family, and they're my cheerleaders and my biggest critic. The second, both of you, ma'am, you and sir have believed in me more than, I hope I don't cry, more than I believed in myself, more than anyone else, anyone has believed in me. You both have really believed in me, and you've given me so many opportunities, and the only thing you've told me is, aap kar sakte ho. You can do it. And that you can do, like Diya said the last time, there's a huge responsibility on your shoulder to give in the best. Because, you know, when both of you say you can do it, it means the world to me. Third is my clients. There are a lot of people who keep telling me, itne sare certifications kiye aapne. Are you like obsessed with the certification or something? No, I am not. All this that I have done it for my clients. Every time they have come back to me, with a problem. I've always looked at how can I be a one-stop shop for them. So all this coaching, NLP, all of that was just to support them and to help them better, and my consultations get better. So my clients, last but not the least, my mentors, my coaches, my actual coaches. In fact, I have my first mentor who was the ex-managing director of Accenture, joined in from Singapore. So that's the kind of support and love that I've got from people. And how can I not change, ma'am, after this? So here I am, the changed Aruna.
Yes, absolutely. And I can definitely feel and sense that change ever since I've known you since last 9 years. I mean, I've seen a lot of difference between the Aruna of that time to the Aruna of today. So there has been a fantastic change, a brilliant change. Great.
Thank you.
So what message would you like to give to those who are looking from a full-time employment to becoming their own boss, considering becoming an image consultant and a soft skills trainer? So any specific message that you have for them?
So people who are already working for them.
And exploring a profession in image consulting and soft skills training.
Okay. So people who are working to start with, image consulting is a fantastic career option. So if you're looking at joining image consulting, you actually don't have to quit your corporate world. You, I mean, you can do it side by side. And if there's no clash of interest, then maybe weekends you can work. And once you have built enough traction, then you can quit. But if there is a clash of interest, then post your training, you can quit and start on your own. The message to the ones who want to start, one is there are three things that I believe you really need to start something on your own. You really need to have patience, you need to have passion, and you need to have perseverance. Passion, ye nahi ki aaj mera passion ye hai, I have to, you know, start something on my own and tomorrow you will start something else. No, passion to do something and you're very sure of what you want to do. Patience, because it's not that today you start, you complete your course, you're out and you start making profits. No, it will take time. You have to be patient enough to hold on to that at least for a year or three, maximum, minimum three. Ek to is like still, I would say at least 3 years. And perseverance, because there will be enough and more people in your life who will tell you, don't do it. You know, you have a good job, why do you want to leave that? So you need to keep looking at ways and means of holding on to that industry. So if you have passion, patience and perseverance, then the time is now to start image consulting.
And just to add to what you have said, I mean, all those people who are exploring image consulting, first set your base right. I mean, get your grip firmly into the ground. Make sure that you have a sturdy profession as an image consultant, and then just think of quitting your job. Because if you decide to quit your job first, I mean, then you are definitely unstable and then you will not be able to focus well in your work. So that's the most important thing. People cannot do business in desperation. So if you become desperate, you will definitely go out of work. So don't be desperate. Balance both the things simultaneously. And once you set your image consulting business well, that is the time when you decide to call it quits to your job. So that is something which I wanted to share with everybody, like how Aruna has said. So last question, Aruna. A lot of people ask this question, that when is the right time to become your own boss? So I would like to know, what, according to you, I mean, when is the right time to become your own boss? I have been
bombarded the time is with now. This
question. I have been bombarded with this question many times. So I want to bombard you with this question, that when is the right time, according to you?
This is the right time. Again, the same things, passion, perseverance and patience. If you have these three things, and you need to look at your client base as a solution provider. If you genuinely want to help people, then this is the time. I mean, just leap. If you're sure that I want to do something for the world, I want to do something meaningful, then just do it. It's now is the time. Take the leap. Don't wait. If you really want to do it, don't wait. Is what I have to say.
Of course. So there is no right time or wrong time. The time is now. Whenever you decide something in life,
absolutely,
it's now. You have to take that plunge and, you know, get into it and make sure that you take an informed decision. And based on that only, your life
absolutely
will
change. Yes.
Fantastic.
Absolutely. And stick to that.
Yes, absolutely. So this was a great Insta Live session with you, and I had a great time interacting with you, because there were a lot of things that we wanted to discuss, thrash out, share, and of course, a lot of value add came through your interaction, whatever you said, because there are a lot of people who are looking up to you and wanted to hear it from you, your experiences and your journey of being a successful image consultant and a soft skills trainer. So in the end, one last thing that I would like to ask you, who is your competitor?
Nobody. I am my own competitor. Ma'am, I just want to make myself better every day than who I was. I don't compete. And like I said, even sometime back, I run my race. I don't run behind anybody. I don't run behind idols. I learn from my idols. I learn from seniors. I will not run behind them. I will run my own race, and I am my own competitor. I don't believe in competition. I don't.
Absolutely. Fantastic. So, Aruna, it was great interacting with you. I had a brilliant time talking to you, and like every time, whenever we interact, we just go overboard with conversation. So it was lovely having you with us as a guest today. And I hope your son also enjoyed this conversation. You can take feedback from him also, because I'm sure that he must have had
sure. a
looking up to you as a mentor, because parents are also mentors for their children. So thank you so much. And for all the guests who are there present on this Insta Live, thank you so much for being there. We will be back with yet another guest next week. So till then, stay tuned. And this is Suman Agarwal and Aruna Das signing off for today. Thank you, Aruna. Thank you once
again. Thank you so much. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for inviting me. Thank you. Bye.